This video represents a CubeSat ESAT, which is an educational model of a satellite created by FIA Space and the Technical University of Madrid. When you hear a word satellite, what comes to mind first? Probably something like this, right? But look, this is also a satellite, which is called an ESAT, and it is an educational nanosatellite based on a CubeSat standard. CubeSats are small satellites, and by small, we mean very small. They are cubes made in units of 10 by 10 by 10 centimeters and weighing less than 1.33 kilograms. The main advantage of the CubeSats is that they are tiny, modular, and inexpensive to build and launch. They are made of standard low-cost parts that are easy to get and test. CubeSats can be used for scientific, educational, commercial purposes, or technology demonstration. The ESAT is composed of a mechanical structure, the attitude determination and control system, an onboard computer, an electrical power system, and a battery manager board. To control the satellite, you need the provided software and the Cosmos command system. The mechanical structure of the ESAT is a very simple aluminum outer structure. Onboard computer, or OBC, is responsible for an onboard data processing and handling. The tasks of the OBC are telecommands, which means sending commands to the satellite, and telemetry handling, which means receiving messages from a satellite, automated responses, and overall control of a satellite's operations, as some subsystems such as payload or attitude control may run into the OBC. It can be called the brain of a satellite. Electrical power system, or EPS, that covers all aspects of power generation, storage, conditioning, distribution, and conversion for all types of space applications. It contains two solar panels. The front side of the solar panel collects the solar power, and the back side connects to the EPS board and charges the batteries. It also contains a battery pack that is on a battery manager board and is used for the energy storage. Attitude Determination and Control System, or ADCS, is responsible for determining satellite's attitude and controlling its motion. It contains sensors, such as sun sensors, which detect the position of the sun and are located on the solar panels and the side panels. Magnetometer, which measures the direction of a geomagnetic field, accelerometers that measure acceleration, and gyroscope that measures the angular velocity. These measurements are provided by the IMU, which is located on the OBC board. Actuators are also included in the ADCS subsystem. ESAT has X and Y axis magnetorquers that generate torque by interacting with the ambient magnetic field, and the reaction wheel, which generates internal torque by the rotation of the wheel. Payload interfaces depend on the mission purpose. The payload could be a camera, a spectrum analyzer, GPS signal collector, or anything you want to observe and analyze. To summarize, the ESAT is an educational model of a nanosatellite. From here, we can see that the nanosatellites are composed of a mechanical structure, an electrical power system, an onboard computer, app, and attitude determination and control system. Here is a question for you. There is one subsystem that big satellites have, but most of the nanosatellites don't. Can you tell which one it is?